today's episode, we're going to look at the Cobra Anti-Armor Trooper, also known as the Bazooka Trooper, from the 25th anniversary line. What's interesting about this figure is that it's a copy of the Cobra Stinger Driver's mold. They're basically carbon copies except with different paints. I picked up this figure because I kind of like that it's it wasn't offered in the vintage run, so it's kind of cool that in the 25th anniversary they had more specialized instead of the generic infantry or the officer. They kind of had more issued more specialized troops. So, you know, you gotta have someone with the bazooka. I mean, it's just common sense. If you're going to have a collection, you need some guy to firing big rockets over their shoulder, and, you know, I think that's cool as hell. I love the detail of this figure. I am going to open it. The big debate was whether to open it or not, but I've come to a conclusion that I'd rather have it displayed, and I'll hang up the file card on the retro wall. So without further ado, we're going to begin the process of opening the figure. So of course, we're going to get the Craftsman. I love this thing. Go to your local Sears and pick one up. It's just, you know, wood, nice wood handle, and it is sharp as hell. So let's go ahead and perform the surgery. I had a poll on my Instagram of whether I should open or not. A lot of people said no. Don't open it. And if you guys are familiar with my channel and if you've seen the retro wall, I basically have figures, Carter figures all over. So here we go. I think I did a nice clean incision. Yeah, that is pretty good. So here's the figure in the packaging. Now, the thing about these modern figures is that stupid little rubber band that they have. So let's work on that. So you see the actual, there's a little piece of tape. And that comes out. A little bit of a different blue than the traditional. It's kind of like a baby blue. And of course, here is the figure stand with the one peg. It's the only knock on the 25th anniversary. As we saw in my review for the Dollar General G.I. Joe figures, they had a double peg. I thought that was a lot better. Ooh, I like the knife here. There's a knife on the side. And let's see. Oh, yep, there it is. He has the Cobra sign underneath his flap jacket. And I guess this is what it's an artillery vest mostly. So we will put him right off the bat. I am seeing there's no place for him to put his pistol. First time you put the figure, you have to look kind of like, there we go. Ooh, he has no hair, he's like a Kojak. Here's his knife. It looks more like a knife sharpener than a knife, so I don't, that's pretty weird. And of course, here's his pistol. Let's That's in there pretty good. You gotta be very careful. Good thing I took an out in physiology. Alright. So I guess he would hold a pistol in one hand and fire the bazooka in the other. I don't think that's practical, and anybody that served knows that. You need both hands to fire an RPG. So accessories aren't plentiful, but then again, he's just going to be blowing up tanks. So that is the Cobra Anti-Armor Trooper. It's pretty nice. I actually like it. I'm glad I took it out. I mean, everybody goes after, like, the Snake Eyes, the Dukes, and all that other stuff. And then army build, it's always, like, the regular infantry or the officers. So sometimes these guys get overshadowed, but I think they're essential to have. I mean, they look phenomenal. They have a specific function. And, you know, they just make your anyone's collection, modern collection, pop. So I definitely like this. So that is the Cobra Anti-Armor Trooper from the 25th Anniversary line. Thank you for watching, and look forward to seeing you in another video. Have a good one. Bye.